Hi, welcome to the Nova Scotia Museum of Natural History. We are here at our turtle tank. These are Eastern painted turtles, Christmas picta picta, which are reptiles. They are a subspecies of the painted turtle. In Canada, we have the Western painted turtle, Midland painted turtle, and Eastern painted turtle. Eastern painted turtles can be found in southeastern Quebec, southern New Brunswick, and Nova Scotia, as well as along the Atlantic coast of the United States. In Nova Scotia, we are likely to find eastern painted turtles in shallow, slow-moving waters like ponds, swamps, marshes, streams, and lakes. They are most common in the southwestern region of the province, and you will find two here at the museum. What does the eastern painted turtle look like? Well, they have smooth, gently rounded carapaces. That's the upper shell. The carapace is usually dark green to black and has yellow and red markings around the edges. The plastron, or lower shell, is tan to yellow. The head and legs of the turtle are black to dark green and have yellow and red streaks. To tell male and female eastern painted turtles apart, we look at the claws and tails. Males generally have longer, thicker tails. Their cloaca, or their bum, is a little further out from the shell. And they have longer front claws than the females. Here at the museum, we have two male turtles. Eastern painted turtles can live about 50 years or more, and they reach sexual maturity around 12 to 15 years old. The two males here at the museum have lived here since the early 1990s, so they are over 30 years old. In the wild, eastern painted turtles eat aquatic insects, both the adult and larval forms, snails, carrion, fish, frogs, and plant material like lily pads. At the museum, we feed our turtles a mix of fish, earthworms, crickets, mealworms, lettuce, and other greens. Female turtles lay eggs. Something interesting about turtles is that the female digs a nest, lays the eggs, and then returns to her regular life. There is no parental care of the eggs or hatchlings. When the eggs hatch, the tiny turtles are completely independent. Sadly, turtle nests often face predation from raccoons, skunks, and human activity like construction and development. Invasive species like chain pickerel, a type of fish, also prey on the hatchlings when they reach the water. In fact, eastern painted turtle populations are now considered of special concern with the Committee on the Status of Endangered Wildlife in Canada, and this is due to continued threats like road mortality, habitat loss and degradation, and invasive species. The two turtles at the museum are animal ambassadors for their species and the other turtles in Nova Scotia. We can learn from them and encourage protection of wildlife and their habitats. When visiting, you may find the turtles basking under their sunlights or stretching their legs as they swim. Take a moment to observe the turtles and chat with staff to learn more about them.